This is an undyed piece of leather. It's a heavily oiled leather, so it's waterproof. As it comes out of the tannery, and I get it from Joseph Clayton's at Chesterfield, straight from the tannery. It's just pinned. So I've pulled this over with lasting pincers, and I've formed it. I haven't heated it up because this is cow hard. It hasn't got any wax in it. It's got a lot of oil in it, but no wax in it. And then I've pulled it down with pincers and I've nailed it, pinned it up. Now, what's going to happen is that I'm going to try them on the lady that's getting them. And then if they need moving anywhere, I can ease this up slightly, or I can make it a bit shallower. So I've left this at this point, just to, you know, before I finish them. Now, this is a ankle strap, and basically they used to go like that. So they go around the ankle, not like that, more like that. And one of the buttons I just showed you would go underneath, and then that would have a hole in the strap, and that's how it would hold. The pattern for it isn't quite the same as this, but this is the only traditional one I've got in, I don't know, it's tin, it's some sort of metal. And this is a child's 8, and this is slightly gothic if you look at it. But there it is. You can see how this comes out there. This is the join at the back. This comes up and stitches together, and the whole pattern comes out of that. This is a one piece, like the ones I used to make. Stitch up the back, one strap. That strap goes over a button, the Japan buttons that's there. So that works like that. And then this is a clasp. So this is the front, which is number 10, which isn't the size 10. I've never quite worked out how they correlate. They tend to be two or three sizes bigger. Factories would make them and send them to clog makers who would buy them. It would be part of the kit. So you'd have your patterns, you'd buy that in. So you'd have your leather patterns, your knives, your bench, your tooker cam, lasting pincers, half round bottom glazer. Not a lot of tools. You never needed a lot of tools. You didn't need many tools. And a few lasts. If you had straight lasts, you could get away with, say, three sizes to a last.